Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited for today's video. It is going to be skincare, the comprehensive how-to guide for beginners. Okay, there's so much to talk about, literally so much to cover. I have got pages and pages of notes of things that I wanted to make sure to pass on to you guys. Before we get started, a quick disclaimer, I am not a doctor, I'm not a chemist, I am not a dermatologist. Everything that I'm talking about is from my own research and my own experience, so take everything I say with a grain of salt. This video is to help you know how to research skincare, not to do your research for you. So just keep that in mind as we go through this. So in thinking about how I wanted to do this, because there really is so much information, and I'm just really like helping you dip your toes in so that you know where to start, and that's really all I'm gonna be able to do in one video. There's so much information. But in thinking about how I wanted to do this, I figured out some basic steps to take you through. I will, along with those steps, give you my experience. I will walk you through my morning and nighttime skincare routines, but that's how I think it's gonna work best, so that you kind of have a starting place for your own skincare journey to commence. Along with that, I need to just give you a quick skincare history for me. I have never had really terrible skin. I've never had really great skin. I've also never had a good skincare routine. I've never been super consistent with a skincare routine. I have always thought of myself as kind of like a low maintenance, easygoing type person. And I think that I felt like I needed some kind of authority figure to tell me what to do. Or I always felt also maybe like a skincare routine that involved more than a couple steps just seemed too high maintenance for me. So I always had like really light acne, but like pretty persistent acne ever since high school. I always thought that by the time I hit my mid-20s that would go away, and it never did, and I was starting to get kind of frustrated. I especially had a really consistent like hormonal breakout every month that would last like pretty much until my next period, like everything would finally heal, and then my next period would start and it would start all over again, and it was really frustrating. I just felt like I was always like perpetually trying to heal my skin, and at the same time not doing all that much to try, because the most that I would do for my skincare routine is like wipe off my makeup at night and put on some moisturizer and then go to bed and wake up and be like, oh, my skin's fine, I don't need to do anything, it's clean, I slept on it, and then put on more makeup. So I really had not much of anything going on. I always have like some salicylic acid on hand, and I felt like that wasn't doing anything for my acne, and I got frustrated with that, and it's because I wasn't using it the right way or at the right time. But yeah, so I really knew nothing when I started researching and understanding this. I've broken this down into steps for you to make it a little bit easier, but for me, I kind of just researched it all at once. And you'll see a lot of these steps kind of overlap, because as you're researching like one part of what I'm about to tell you, other things will pop up that you're gonna wanna remember too. So just kind of keep that in mind. The name of the game is research, honestly. Research and trial and error. Skincare is all about prevention and patience, I think. This is a long-term game. If you are young watching this, great. I am excited for you, because the younger you start, the better your skin's gonna be later. If you are older, that's great too. You might have some different things that you're dealing with though than probably what I'm dealing with, so that's especially important to remember. As I share what products I use, they're gonna be different depending on your needs and depending on your stage of life. Your skin is the largest organ on your body. You should be taking care of it like every other aspect of your health. And beauty starts from the inside out, and I really believe that like skincare is self-care. There is something spiritual about taking extra care of your face and waking up each day knowing that you have done what you can do. And I really think that that's the number one thing that's helped my confidence with how my skin looks. I really don't think my face looks that much different, probably objectively. Like, probably all of you guys who have watched other videos of mine, you probably can't even see a difference with my skin, honestly. But I feel it, and I feel better about myself because I know I'm taking care of myself. So that's kind of what like my greatest wish for you is that you'll take this as like some motivation and inspiration to spend more time on self-care, to spend more time building your self-confidence, and if that requires a few extra skincare products, like, isn't that worth it? Okay, there we go. Background on me, that's my philosophy, that's kind of my mindset with all of this. Let's jump into the steps, which are the most important part of this whole video. Step number one is figure out your priorities. Everyone is going to have different skin issues that they want to treat that they are worried about. For me, it was taking care of my pores. I just felt like my pores looked big and dirty. I wanted to shrink them. I wanted to make sure I was cleaning them properly. The other thing is obviously getting rid of that little persistent acne that I was dealing with, that I was so sick of dealing with. The third thing is trying to improve my skin's texture and tone. I've always had like little, just a redness around my nose. I've always had pretty good dark circles under my eyes. I have always had just kind of like a not a baby soft, smooth, fresh feeling skin texture. So I really wanted to try to improve that a little bit. And the overall umbrella over all these things is long-term prevention. I didn't want any of that to get worse or cause permanent damage down the road. So that's kind of what I was dealing with. You might be dealing with dry skin, oily skin, persistent redness, extra sensitivity to certain things. There's so many things that might be different than what I'm dealing with. So just take some time and think about that first. You're not gonna be able to build a good skincare routine without figuring out what you want to treat for your skin. Step number two is researching what products treat the things that you want to treat. Part of this, as you're starting to do this research, you will also start to see little tidbits of information about like what works with what. Also, like why it works is really important to kind of pay attention to. This is where you kind of start to just dip your toes into some of the chemistry of skincare, and you'll start to realize that's where we start to get into like the scientific names of things, which I think is really important to learn, and all of that kind of stuff. So for me, these are like the things that I thought might treat what I was dealing with the best. I will just go over that. Like I said, you're gonna have different issues and you're kind of probably gonna need to look for different things, but this is what I discovered might work for what I was dealing with. First of all, for shrinking my pores, deep cleaning them, a toner. Something that's really common that pretty much probably everyone should be using is an alpha hydroxy acid toner. That comes in many different forms, from one that you can leave on all the time, which is what I like to use, to one that you only leave on for a few minutes. It is a chemical exfoliant, so instead of scrubbing off the top layer of your skin, you're letting this acid do it for you, and it helps with your skin turnover. You are gonna get fresh, clean looking skin more often. It's gonna help with clogged pores because you just don't have all the dead skin cells sitting on the surface of your skin. So that was the number one thing that I wanted to use for helping the appearance of my pores. For getting rid of acne, there's a couple things that I introduced to my skincare routine that have made a huge difference for me with acne. The number one thing is niacinamide. Honestly, if I had to get rid of everything else in my skincare routine and I could only have one thing, it would be niacinamide. It has made a huge difference in my skin. Niacinamide helps with sebum activity, which is the protective layer that sits right on top of your skin. The harder that layer is working, the less acne you're gonna have, the less redness you're gonna have, the less clogged pores you're gonna have. I really honestly love niacinamide so much. The other thing is spot treatments. I started using tea tree oil, which is an antibacterial because bacteria is what makes acne. Also salicylic acid, I mentioned I used that before, but I started using it the right way and that helps a lot. And retinoids. Retinoids are a whole family of products. There's retinol, which is in a lot of things for anti-aging that you see. There's retinoic acid, which is in like prescription acne treatments. And then there's retinoids, which are like somewhere in between those two things. Stronger than retinols, less strong than retinoic acid. The jury's still out on whether retinoids really help with acne, but it's in the same family as acne treatments, so I don't know why it wouldn't help, but it is also mainly marketed for anti-aging. So keep that in mind. I put it under the get rid of acne category because I think that has helped me also. For evening my skin's texture and tone, again, toner, improving the turnover of your skin, very important. Retinoids, that's also gonna help with your collagen production. It's that's why it's mainly marketed for anti-aging, because it helps with wrinkles, helps your skin look more youthful and young, because collagen is key for healthy, youthful, plump looking skin. Vitamin C is something that I introduced to my skincare routine to help with skin texture and tone. It is an antioxidant. Antioxidants are very important for your skin. They help your skin look bright and youthful. Antioxidants are important for every part of your body, so make sure you're eating your antioxidants too. But vitamin C is the version that is good for your skin. Some other things that I introduced that are kind of part of texture and tone, I put them under that category just because they kind of are their own thing. I wanted to introduce some kind of eye treatment cream to help with the circles under my eyes, so I use caffeine for that. It's also, jury's still out on whether caffeine really helps with under eye circles. Skincare Edit, I think, believes that more has to do with like thyroid and hormones and stuff, but I have seen a difference with using a caffeine treatment around my eyes. I also use it around my nose, and that's helped with my like redness too, because caffeine shrinks the little veins that sit right under the surface of your skin, which makes your skin look red. So I like caffeine for that, but just keep in mind that might not work for everybody. Also, a hyaluronic acid. If you have dry skin, hyaluronic acid is the tiniest little molecule that you can put on your skin. It penetrates deeply and then it attracts water. I think it can attract like 1,000 times its weight or size or something in water. I can't remember, but hyaluronic acid is really great if you are dealing with like dry skin, which can really affect your skin's texture. Hyaluronic acid is really great for that. And the last thing that I mentioned that I was concerned with is long-term care. All of these products are going to help with that. I think the main thing that's going to make a difference with that is consistency. Do not stop. Start and don't stop. Do it your whole life. Make it part of your life. Make it part of your self-care. Make it something that's fun to do, something that feels like a treat. That's going to be the key to really preventing a lot of the skin issues that you will get when you're older, is starting now and sticking with it. After you have figured out what products will treat what you're worried about, which I forgot to mention, but by the way, will change with time. This is not something that you only need to do once. As you get older, your needs will change. So make sure to kind of evaluate. Once you've kind of taken care of some of the issues that you've had, maybe it's time to reevaluate what your priorities are for your skincare routine. Do that every so often. Okay, step number three is to take all those types of things that you think will help your issues and figure out when and how to use them. Along with that is figuring out what kinds of forms they come in, trying to figure out what might work best for you. For instance, obviously if you have a really oily face, maybe using all oils isn't a really great idea for you. If you have a really dry face, maybe you need things that are a little bit more moisturizing instead of drying. That's where that really comes into play and is individual to each person. And you know, basically the form that these things will come in will become really important as you start to actually build your routine. So start thinking about that and researching what kinds of things will work best for your skin. A lot of the products that I use, I will show you all of them in a minute, but I really love The Ordinary. The Ordinary is a great resource for understanding the chemistry behind what's in your skincare also. Their products are like super basic and they say exactly what's in them, the chemical makeup of them on the bottle, and their website is like a wealth of knowledge. So this is not sponsored in any way by them. I just love them. A lot of people love them. They've kind of revolutionized the skincare industry that way. They are super affordable. It's a great place to start. So if you are feeling like, oh my gosh, there's so many products to use and most of them are like $50 each, go to The Ordinary. They're gonna be your best bet to start figuring out the skincare routine that you might want to build. So as you're researching what forms to take with these products, there are a few rules that will help you narrow down what you want to use and when. Rule number one is kind of treat it the same as hair care, where you don't really want to use more than three like active ingredients at a time. That's like a long-standing rule in hair care. If you're like, as you're styling, you don't want to use more than three products because it just gets to be too much on your hair. And it's going to be the same with your skin. Your skin can't endlessly absorb things, so you kind of want to stick to like maybe three active ingredients along with like a cleanser and a moisturizer on either end slash like a sunscreen. So kind of keep that in mind. And then another very important rule to remember is as you're building your routine, you want to start lightest to heaviest. So that's where the form that your products take starts to really matter. You need to know that, because if you're putting on your products lightest to heaviest, you're going to want to start with like anything that you wash off, you want to use first, obviously. And then you want to use like water-based serums from wateriest up to like thickest, and then move into like any oils, and then like your moisturizers, creams, and sunscreens and stuff. Kind of think of it as like oil can penetrate water, but water can't really penetrate oil as it sits on your skin. And there are some ingredients that do not play nice together. All of them are great for your skin, not all of them are great for your skin at the same time. For instance, an alpha hydroxy acid or any kind of acid that is an exfoliant, you are never gonna wanna use with any kind of retinoid because they do the same thing in different ways. So if you use them at the same time, you will end up with really red, dry, irritated skin. You don't want that. There's also pH balances to all of these ingredients, which means if you're using an ingredient with this pH level that's really high, and then right on top of it you put an ingredient with this pH balance that's really low, they're gonna cancel each other out and you will be wasting product. So for instance, vitamin C and niacinamide will do that. You never want to use them in at the same time. You can use them in the same routine. I use one in the morning, one at night. Never use them like right after. It's pretty easy to find like what specific ingredients you don't want to share. That's just some examples. Pay attention to like how to use the different products also, so that any specific instructions from the manufacturer you can follow. There's also certain ingredients that work better in the morning than at night, or vice versa. Vitamin C I like using in the morning because it's brightening. Any kind of retinoid you're gonna want to use at night because it increases skin sensitivity to UV rays, which means that you will be asking for a sunburn if you put on retinoids in the morning. So keep things like that in mind. Also, I know that's a lot of little rules, but I hope that helps you just like with some basic things to look out for. Okay, step number four is something we haven't even touched on yet, which is arguably the most important part of your whole routine, and that is your cleanser. You cannot build a good routine over dirty skin. You have to clean your skin first. This is one thing that I realized I was doing all wrong, and that was not properly cleansing my skin. I am religious about it now, morning and night, no matter what, but I, up until recently, was not. And what I used to do is I used to use just like a makeup remover, which was like a lotion, so it had kind of like a lotiony, oily feel. I would just take my makeup off with that and then put moisturizer on. And then the first skincare product that I added was niacinamide, and I would just put my niacinamide right over my makeup remover after I took off my makeup. My niacinamide probably wasn't even properly penetrating my skin because I still had like all of the residue from the makeup remover on it. And yeah, so double cleansing is super important. That is where you take off your makeup first with some kind of lotion, oil, whatever, and then you cleanse your skin with like an actual cleanser. And this comes from like the Korean, I think it's like 12-step beauty skincare routine. I can't remember how many steps, it's so many steps, but this comes from that. It's kind of a Korean philosophy in makeup and beauty, and I love it. Obviously, you only need to take off your makeup at night, not in the morning, so in the morning you can skip the makeup remover step. I like to use like a lotion or milk cleanser. I have this one from Clinique, which is the Take the Day Off Cleansing Milk, and this one from Aveeno, which is a 3-in-1 makeup remover. They're both kind of lotiony. I spread them on my face with my hands, and then I wipe them off with a cotton pad, as you will see in my nighttime routine, and this is my makeup remover. I never use waterproof mascara. If you use waterproof mascara and eye makeup, then you're gonna have to take that off with like some kind of oil, but I don't, so I can just take that off with water. After I take off my makeup, then I use a cleanser. Cleansers, you're gonna need to do some research on too. Sorry, I know I warned you in the beginning, lots of research, but there are lots of different types of cleansers, believe it or not. I discovered that for my skin, foaming cleansers are too harsh. Foam tends to take off more oils from your skin, and I didn't really need that. If you have a really oily complexion, you might want to use a foam cleanser, but I didn't need one. So I started researching like gel cleansers, jelly cleansers, all of that kind of stuff. And I ended up with this enzyme cleansing gel from Mario Badescu, which I really like. This brand is kind of underrated, I think, but it's very gentle and awesome, and it is a gel. So you literally like spread it on your face and it just stays where you put it, and then I just rub it and it doesn't foam. So this is what I use, and I love this. You will see it in my skincare routine. Again, I do use this morning and night. And at the very end of my routine, I need moisturizers. I have several that I'm honestly still testing out. I haven't 100% picked one that I'm gonna stick with yet, but as of right now, for the morning, I'm switching back and forth between a couple of them. A super cult classic in France, which I do love because it wears so well under makeup, is this Embryolisse Le Creme Concentrate, which you used to not be able to get in the US. but you can now, and it's really not that expensive. I think it's like $16, and it is a cult classic with the beauty community because it wears so well under makeup, but it isn't as hydrating. So if you need something more hydrating, this is not going to be your best option. Another one that I'm testing out that I really like for the morning is this Saturday Skin Waterfall Glacier Water Cream. I just have this little travel size. I got it with my like Sephora points. So it starts off as kind of like a gel, and then once you warm it up like on your face, it starts to kind of turn kind of watery, but it dries down pretty quickly, and I do really like it. It's just really expensive. I think it's like $40 for a big one, so I don't know if I'm gonna keep using it, but I do really like this one for something lighter in the morning. And for at night, I have been using this Fresh Rose Deep Hydration Face Cream, and this is another trial size that I got that I actually think I might be buying the big one of. It's also kind of on the more expensive side, but this is really the one area that I splurge is moisturizer. Moisturizers last a long time, especially if you're using other products first. So I think it's worth it. I haven't really found cheap moisturizers that do what more expensive moisturizers do, so it's worth it to me. But I do really love this one. It smells great, and it really keeps everything locked in and nice and moist. Like, I wake up with really great skin every day, I think thanks to this moisturizer. So I just showed you the very beginning and the very end of my routine. That's the kind of area that I think you have a little more forgiveness as far as what you're using. Your face usually isn't gonna break out or have more issues due to one of those things. It's probably going to react first to like one of the more active ingredients that you're using. So I just wanted to get this out of the way, because I'll just show you what I use and you can experiment yourself. I do think that trial sizes and using like Sephora points to try out some of the more expensive products is a great idea. You'll still get a lot of wear out of them, and they're a heck of a lot cheaper to try out if you don't love them. After you have figured out where your priorities are, and then figured out what kinds of ingredients and chemicals will work for you to help treat those things, and then figured out when to use those, how to use them, what forms they can take, and then figured out what kinds of cleansers and moisturizers you think you might want to use, it is time to build your routine. Now, like I mentioned, start lightest to heaviest. That's going to be your baseline, but you will find that there's some experimentation needed. There were definitely days where I had products pilling up when I was rubbing extra things on, where I just felt like I didn't need quite so much, I was using too much, where I had like a greasy face because things weren't sinking in properly. So this is kind of where there's like, you're gonna have to take some time to figure this out. But I will show you my current routine and I will walk you through it. So for the morning, first of all, I wash my face with my enzyme cleansing gel. I love this stuff. It is light, it smells good, it tastes good. You're not supposed to eat it, don't eat it, but you know, it's happened. It's simple, it's refreshing. After that, I use a toner. Right now, I'm really liking this glycolic acid from The Ordinary. There are tons of options for toners. I like this one because it's really light, it dries down quickly, and I don't have to rinse it off. It's very gentle. So I use that right after I wash my face in the mornings. After I have let my toner dry down for a while, I put on a little bit of my vitamin C serum. I picked the serum from The Ordinary. It is an absorbable glucoside solution, 12%. I don't know how to pronounce that. Sorry if I got that wrong. Absorbable glucoside is a more stable version of vitamin C. It's like a derivative of it. It is not as strong as straight vitamin C, and it will last longer on your shelf. It's got like a year-long shelf life. This one from The Ordinary is pretty affordable, and I like it. It honestly is a little bit sticky, so if you wear heavier makeup, it's not gonna wear really well under that. But there's lots of other vitamin C solutions for you, so experiment. This is the one that I like though. After that, I like to put on my eye serum, which right now I'm using The Ordinary Caffeine Plus EGCG. I just gently pat slash rub this all around my eyes. Keep in mind, do not rub hard around your eyes or you will be causing the wrinkles that you're trying to prevent with all these products. I think it dries down really well. Like I mentioned, I also put a little bit around my nose to help with that redness, and I let that dry down for just a minute, and then I would put on hyaluronic acid if I needed it. Right now, it is still hot in New York City and humid. I do not need any extra moisture for my skin. I've found that hyaluronic acid, along with all these other products in the summertime, just makes my skin too greasy and just, it's not great. So I skip the hyaluronic acid right now, but I am keeping this in here just in case you might want it, and or I might start using it in the winter right in this part of my routine. Then before I put on my moisturizer and head out for the day, I would use any spot treatment also. I didn't need any today. I do have a couple little marks from my period, but it's nothing that needs to be treated. It's already stuff that is healing, so I didn't want to add any extra like oils or acids to that, but this is where you would want to put on a little bit of spot treatment if you needed it. If you felt like your skin needed some extra penetration power, you would probably want to put it on before anything else. But yeah, I like to put it on here because I like to have a little bit of space between my AJ toner and my, if I'm using salicylic acid, my salicylic acid, because that's just a lot of acid on your skin. So I would use that here, and then I put on my moisturizer. Today I used the Saturday Skin Waterfall Glacier Water Cream, and I am off for the day. Super fast, that whole thing took 11 minutes to film, and that was with waiting at least a couple minutes between products. So really not a long routine. And like I mentioned in the rules section, step number 3, I did not use more than about 3 active ingredients in my routine for the day. I also should mention the vitamin C, the hydrating serum, the eye serum, all those things are all water-based. I didn't use any oil-based products in my morning routine. All of it dries down really nice, and it's all kind of a light, kind of almost not sticky, I don't know, serum-y feeling. It's none of it is really heavy or creamy. At the end of your morning routine, you should be using a sunscreen, especially if you are outside at all during the day. I am not. And also, I haven't really found any sunscreens that I love. I think mineral sunscreens are supposed to be way better than some of the other kinds of sunscreens. But honestly, comment below if you have any sunscreens that you like, because I haven't found any that I love yet, and I know I'm supposed to be using one, and this is where it's supposed to be in your routine, but I just have not figured that out yet. And now we move on to my nighttime routine. Like I mentioned, I mostly wear Glossier products, so it's really light. There's not a ton of makeup to take off, and I don't use anything that's waterproof. So makeup remover is obviously the first step, and it is quick and easy. I use a cotton pad and a little bit of the Avène 3-in-1 makeup remover, or the Clinique Take the Day Off Cleansing Milk, and I rub that all over my face, wipe it off with my cotton pad. It does not get off everything, but it gets off most of it, and that is important, I think, because there's no way that my awesome enzyme cleansing gel could get off all my makeup in one sweep. So after my makeup remover and cleansing gel, I am ready to start on my serums. This is where I would put on my hyaluronic acid if I was using it. Like I mentioned, I'm not using it right now because I don't need it, but this is where I would use it at night. I know it's at a different spot in my routine than in the morning. That's because in the morning I use a toner, and the toner needs to go right on my clean skin for maximum penetration. But at night I'm not using any kind of acid toner. So I'd probably put on hyaluronic acid here if I was using it. After that, I will use my niacinamide. This niacinamide from The Ordinary feels almost like a gel, but it's not. But you want to really give it a little bit of time to sink in. I have found in my research that a lot of people deal with the niacinamide pilling underneath other products, which means that it kind of just bunches up and doesn't actually get deep into your skin with like any kinds of oily things on top of it. So in order to prevent that, there are a couple tips that I will share with you at the end of the video, but I try to use a very small amount of niacinamide, spread that all over my face, and give it a minute or two to like actually sink in. Sometimes I'll brush my teeth here or do other things while I wait. I'll also put on my eye serum, again, my caffeine plus EGCG, all around my eyes and around my nose. I use my eye serum morning and night. After that, I will put on my retinoid. I am using this Gran Active Retinoid 2% in squalane from The Ordinary again. Squalane is an oil. It is really great for skin. You'll see it in tons of different skincare products that you're using. And the reason I'm using this is because it's only a 2% solution, which means that it's not super strong, and the squalane even helps it like be diluted further and be less irritating. Lots of different retinol, retinoid, retinoic acid products can be really irritating on your skin. So I use this, and it has not caused any irritation for me. So I put that on. I try to very gently pat it into my skin so that I don't disturb the niacinamide underneath. Because I am following the lightest to heaviest rule, the niacinamide is a water serum. I use that, and then I use the retinoid over it, which is an oil, and they tend to not mix super great. So I am very careful with when I put this on. I'm kind of thinking about maybe trying out some different retinoids than this one eventually. There is an emulsion from the Ordinary that is water-based, and there's lots of other product options that I have not explored, but for now this is what I have, and I have really enjoyed using a retinoid in my routine, so this is what I'll stick with for now. After this, I would use any of my other spot treatments if I needed them. I don't need any right now, so I didn't use any, but this is again where I use like my salicylic acid or tea tree oil or anything else like that. Spot treat acne and things. Luckily, I didn't need to treat anything, so I can move on to my heavy moisturizers. For my heavy moisturizer, like I mentioned, I use the Fresh Rose Deep Hydration Moisturizer. I love it at night. It would be way too heavy under makeup in the daytime, but at night when I have a whole 8 hours for my skin to rest and sink in all these good ingredients, it works great. It locks everything in. I really like it. Okay, we've talked a lot about face. There's so many products for your face. But I have not mentioned one other very important thing. Your body, the rest of your body is covered in skin also, and it also needs a little bit of love. I don't do a ton. I mostly just make sure I moisturize after I shower and especially after I shave, and I dry brush. I cannot recommend dry brushing enough. I think it has single-handedly kept my legs soft and smooth this summer and not too dry. I love how it feels. I always do it right before my shower, and because you are literally brushing your skin and brushing up towards your heart, all of your blood rushes to the surface of your skin and your whole body feels tingly. It's the weirdest thing, but it's so great. And along with that blood rushing to the surface of your skin, that means that you're getting extra hydration, extra circulation. It's just overall really good for your health. So highly recommend dry brushing. This one is from Eco Tools. My mom gave it to me, so I have no idea where you can buy this, but you can get them everywhere. Dry brush. I highly recommend it for the rest of your body as regular exfoliation and increasing circulation. If you have any other tips also for your body, great. I just don't tend to need a lot. My skin is pretty fine on its own. And I just wanted to also share some really quick tips, different ways that you can kind of troubleshoot if you are having trouble figuring out your skincare routine, if things just aren't working, if things are pilling, if your face feels really oily or greasy. These are some things that I have found that could help you. Tip number one for pilling is to mix your products together before you put them on your face. So for instance, if you're using like a couple different water-based serums and layering them one on top of the other is making things so heavy that it's not sinking in, use half the amount of each, mix them together before you put them on your face, and then put them on at the same time. That will help your skin not only absorb all the ingredients, but you'll probably actually be using the amount that you really need. I think sometimes if you do each one individually, you end up with like putting way too much on your face. So mixing the ingredients together before you put them on your face is really gonna help with that. And there's also this thing called short contact therapy. Any of these active ingredients, niacinamide, vitamin C, all that stuff, if you are feeling like your products are just too heavy, things aren't sinking in, try short contact therapy where you put it on your skin, you leave it for like at least half an hour to let things sink in, and then you go ahead and rinse it off. And then you won't have the residue of that stuff on your skin, and your skin will already have absorbed the best parts of whatever that serum that you're using is. So that's another thing that you can try if you want to kind of like lighten things up on your face. I haven't needed to do that, but I feel like that would be really great if you have the time for it. It does make your skincare routine quite a bit longer. And if you feel like you've tried all those things and they're not working, some other things to think about: are you mixing waters and oils? I know I showed you mixing waters and oils in my routine at night, but at night I have time to let things sink in and I use very small amounts, and that's helped. So think about maybe like using less of each thing. Are you using things in the right order, lightest to heaviest, waters and then oils? That could be your problem. Make sure you know what's in your products. Make sure you're looking at ingredients. And the other thing that you might not be doing is waiting long enough in between things. So maybe think about that if you're having trouble. Okay guys, that was it. I'm going to put on the screen. Hopefully those are helpful to you. Some of my final thoughts. Really just that taking care of your body is a lifestyle. It's a choice that you have to make every day. to spend that extra time and money on your body, on yourself, on your face. It's not always easy, it's not always fun, but it's important. This is the house that you have to live in for your entire life. Like I said, I was literally just taking off my makeup and I'm, you know, putting on moisturizer and that was it. But just even adding niacinamide to my routine made a huge difference in my skin and really started me on the path to skincare. So just start with one thing. Niacinamide is $6 from The Ordinary. You have no excuse not to try it. My biggest wish for you is that you will walk away from this video feeling a little more confident, a little more excited about taking care of your skin, starting on the skincare journey. It's a journey and I'm on it here with you. I can't wait to hear about how it goes. Make sure to comment below as you start like working on all this stuff. I want to know about it. I want to know what products work for you. If you have anything that works better, you think, than what I'm using, please tell me because I'm so interested. And guys, I think that covers it. Like this video if you made it to the end because that means that you liked it. Subscribe for more content. I'm an author tuber, but here I am doing skincare. I do all kinds of stuff. I think next week might be like a no heat hair lifestyle kind of a video. I do weekly vlogs, so subscribe for more. And can't wait to see you in the next one.
We can, as long as it fits our calories, we can go get one.
Look, he's putting his shoes on. It's real. Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. I'm so excited.
Say.
I just said, look, he's putting his shoes on. It's real.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I've been craving a hamburger too, so that's an excuse for
this
me.
This is the best day of all the days! I'm not getting a meal though. No soda. I'm not doing soda. Wait, do you want that?
We'll see.
Okay. Okay, I might get soda. I might. We'll see.